New Zealand sets a 90% vaccination target before ending its strict lockdown measures. Once the poster child for stamping out COVID-19, New Zealand has been hit by the highly infectious Delta variant, with Auckland bearing the brunt of the surge. It reported 129 new cases on Friday, a new daily record for the third time this week.
The more people who are vaccinated, the harder it is for COVID to spread through communities quickly and find our most vulnerable. That means while we used to say that we needed to stay home to save lives, we now need to be vaccinated to save lives. And this is where New Zealand has the chance to continue to carve our own path. Very few countries have had the opportunity to vaccinate people before COVID was in every corner of their communities. We can. Once we have done that, we then need to make sure we keep using that tool to protect ourselves as we gradually and carefully open up.
The U.S. Centers for Disease Control and Prevention recommends booster shots for recipients of Moderna and Johnson & Johnson vaccines. This is aligned with the Food and Drug Administration's authorization, clearing those two vaccine brands for use as boosters. The U.S. CDC says all vaccines authorized in the country are highly effective in reducing the risk of hospitalization and death, even with the Delta variant. So far, about 11.6 million Americans have received a booster dose. Melbourne residents flocked to the city's cafes Friday after the world's most locked-down city emerged from the latest spate of COVID restrictions. Its reopening will be a boost for the country's economy after recent lockdowns pushed it to the brink of a second recession in as many years. Australia's second-largest city has so far endured nearly 9 months of restrictions during six separate lockdowns since March 2020.
Today is a great day. We've got out of jail. We are so, so happy. These last 11 weeks have been very, very hard on us. They really have. This is our sixth lockdown, and this one really damaged us. You know, we've been very depressed and very concerned. Us as business owners, we've been concerned about the rent that we have to pay.
Over 70% of adults in Australia are now fully vaccinated. Many residents are planning to fly overseas again as international border restrictions start to ease from November.